This is a Gree mini split air conditioner, and its outdoor PCB is currently working perfectly. You can see that its light is also on, and apart from that, the PCB has successfully completed all its other functions as well. The problem here is that the indoor unit is showing an E6 error. Let me turn off the light and show you. As you can see, the E6 error is appearing here. As you can see, I have turned the unit back on. The unit is operating at a temperature of 16, and its connections are also perfectly fine. This is a communication error, so the first thing we will do is check the communication in the system. I have set the multimeter to DC voltage, and it's currently working perfectly. The unit's communication is absolutely fine, and there is no issue with it. The voltage fluctuations are also completely normal. However, despite all this, the unit is still not functioning. I have rechecked the electrical connections as well. Now, the first step in my process is to perform a physical inspection. When I closely examine the capacitors on this PCB, you can see that there is a spark mark here. This indicates a possible short circuit in this area, which means the capacitors might have developed some issues. However, we'll get a clearer understanding after opening it up. So I'll open it now and provide you with more details on what's wrong with this PCB. I have now removed the PCB from the outdoor unit, and I will test it. Take a look at the first point I showed you earlier. You can see there is a visible short circuit here. Currently, I have provided it with direct power, which is why it is turning on and working. I will now check a few points on this PCB to identify the exact issue. As you can see, it has also completed the switching process. Now, let's check a few points. For this, you will need a multimeter as well as a tester like this. First, let's check the neutral point. Since testers do not work on the neutral point, we will check it from the line. Look, the tester's light turns on, which means our electrical supply is perfectly fine. Now, the first thing I will do is set the multimeter to AC voltage. First, I'll check this point, and as you can see, it's showing 236 volts. Next, after passing through the double line filter, I'll check it again. After filtering, you can see that it still shows 236 volts. Now, as you can see, everything up to rectification is perfectly fine. I will now check the rectification in DC voltages. And when I have connected the probes on these pins here, we're getting 322 volts DC. Now I will change the probes, and as you can see, everything is perfectly fine. Now, let's check the capacitor where we suspected the short circuit earlier. As you can see, it is perfectly fine. After that, I'll check the next two capacitors, and they are also in good condition. Now, let's check the IPM. It's showing a voltage drop to 322 volts, and all three points are showing the same voltage, which means the voltages are perfect. Now let's check the next point, where we are getting 1.480 volts. The issue with this PCB is that the 15 volts are missing. I have opened up the PCB further, and as you can see, the front side looks completely fine, and the back side is also in good condition. However, there seems to be a small problem at this point, and it's not working. We need to start this and troubleshoot the issue, but I will share more details with you in the next video. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.